Well, I'll spray it with the inkjet fix varnish. It's giant inkjet fix mats. Probably you can buy something else that will do a better job. I don't know, this smells really horrible, diesel. It dries, it evaporates eventually, but still you can always smell it after there is a hint of smell. So you basically shake this can. There is a bowl inside, quite vigorous. I mean, I would shake it for 20 seconds. I mean, already have shaken it for about half a minute. So I would always spray somewhere else initially, just to clear the nozzle, and then it's a smooth motion across. Well, I'll try to do it smooth, but. No, it's not from too much of a distance, let's say 15-20 centimeters or so, 10 to about 15 to 20, and you don't want to really put too much the first layer. You don't really need to put too much of this varnish. So let's see how this goes. Always wear gloves. So let's see how this looks like. This is how it's at the moment. Still a bit wettish, but it will dry. It will become matte. So it probably needs about, let's say, I'll leave it for about half hour or so to dry, and then I'll put a second coat on top. So I'm doing my lamp is crushing. I'm doing this in my kitchen, so I'll put the ventilator to ventilate the smell. I waited roughly half an hour. Now I'll do a quick second coat. So shake it. Yeah, not. I mean, vigorously, but not too much. And of course, spray somewhere on a kitchen tissue. So I've put some kitchen tissue around, so it just absorbs a bit of the varnish. So spray it somewhere outside to clear the nozzle. And then it's a quick blast, not too much, otherwise it becomes shiny rather than matte. Well, that's it. So it's another half an hour to let this dry. Another half hour passed, and these are pretty safe to touch. You can easily touch somewhere else where you spray it. You can see it's pretty dry and basically safe to touch now, and protects them quite well. There are some imperfections. I mean, you can't quite see it on the video, but there is a bit of a dust particle there. So when I print those, I'll print quite a few, because my environment is not really dust free, and there are a few more. So I'll print out a few and try to cover it with something on top, just not to have dust particles fall on the paper. But this will do for this video. Alright, this one is a bit better. I mean, there are no such particles. This is with the permanent marker, so you can probably compare the two. So the colors here on the top are a bit washed out, and on the bottom a bit redder. So this is a bit washed out, this is quite a bit redder, so it's much nicer. So the next process, because this is fairly flimsy, and I mean it doesn't really have a support, so when you put it in you want something to be slightly harder to almost have the same feel as the original one. So I normally put a transparency film underneath and spray it with the glue, this 3M spray mount adhesive, so it glues and sets and becomes pretty hard. So there is the shiny side, or the that doesn't have adhesive, so I would normally put the rough side underneath, get them together, align them, and I would just spray it and glue them together, put them in the book for overnight, and then cutting out those the bits for the needle and for the LCD screen. And for this this other design, because my LED lights glow orange, and the white so the white lines and the numbers, everything that's white will glow orange, but if you have LEDs that are normal light, they're not colored. So I have a transparency paper where I've printed some weird coloring just to show how one can do it. I mean, I haven't tried it, I don't know. I don't really have a non-orange LED, so I've printed on transparency. Basically the black will somehow slightly block the light, and all the rest are green. I mean, you can see these are red, so these are green. Hopefully if the LEDs are not colored, this will shine through as green. And basically the process is you put it at the back, and you have to align them, so you have to do it under light. It's just easier to align them. So I would align them nearly perfect. I mean, they have to be perfect, and this takes a bit of time to align. But you can see this, well, probably the video doesn't do it justice, but the white bits are glowing red, green. Also, that's white, and that's green, maybe like that. Still doesn't, but it is quite green, and the rest are reddish color. And you would clip them with some sort of clamps to keep it steady. Once you align them, after you align them, keep them steady with two clamps, and then you basically flick it, spray it, flick it back, and hopefully it will stay aligned. I mean, I've done two of these and they stay aligned, but if it doesn't stay aligned, I would have a few of these copies and then do another one. So you might really, of these designs or your design, you might want to print quite a few in order if you make them, to account for making a mistake.